This presentation talks about different projection techniques for a DLP-based smart speaker projector for wall and tabletop projection. We will look at several common projection lens design approaches, as well as a suggested design concept to reduce size, complexity, and cost. Smart speaker projectors are typically projected onto a wall or onto a tabletop. Since the projected image plane is close to the projector, and a large image is desired, the optical designs are known as ultra-short throw designs. There are three common optical design architectures for a smart speaker projector application. The first uses a convex mirror, which can be either aspheric or freeform. Due to the diverging light rays from the rest of the optics of the projection lens, the convex mirror is typically large. A large housing is also required, along with a large opening such that the projected light rays are not blocked. It is common that in a convex mirror design, the mirror can be found exposed and unprotected to avoid the large housing, which can pose many risks to the optic. An alternative to the convex mirror is the concave mirror. The concave mirror can also be aspheric or freeform and converges the light in the path towards the image plane. This allows for a smaller mirror and smaller housing since the size of the light ray bundle is smaller than that of the convex mirror. In the concave mirror design, the mirror is typically protected within the housing of the projector. Image offset is required for the optical rays to clear the lenses and mechanics after reflecting from the mirror toward the image plane. This image offset can be achieved by shifting the digital micromirror device, also known as the DMD, and designing the projection lens for a larger field. This results in larger, more complex optics in addition to the optional curved mirror. It is important to note that these projection architectures allow for a rectilinear distortion-free image. A lower-cost optical design for a smart speaker may incorporate simple tilting of the projection lens without the need of a curved mirror. The tilting of the projection lens relative to the image plane eliminates the need for optical image offset and thus results in smaller, lower-cost optics. Since the projector is now tilted relative to the image plane, this introduces keystone distortion and defocus towards one side of the image. The partial image defocus can be fixed by an optical method known as Scheimpflug. As mentioned previously, tilting a projector will not only induce keystone distortion, which may be tolerated, but also a partially defocused image towards one side. To correct the defocus issue, the Scheimpflug principle states that an object plane, or DMD in this case, can be tilted to compensate for the tilted image plane. The image would still exhibit keystone distortion, but would be in focus throughout the entire image. This keystone distortion is then manageable through electronic distortion correction or image processing to produce a rectilinear image. One thing to note about the Scheimpflug principle is that it is not commonly used in projection. Since the projection throw distance can vary depending on use case, the magnification of the projected image changes. The Scheimpflug principle works for a fixed throw distance only, since the object or DMD must be tilted by the inverse of the magnification of the image. If the magnification varies, then the DMD tilt must also vary, which would require expensive moving mechanical parts and is not recommended. For a smart speaker application with a fixed projection distance, this technique becomes feasible, providing several advantages to cost savings and size reduction. Using the Scheimpflug principle can also be combined with DMD offset. As you can see on the left-hand side, using DMD offset only to achieve image offset results in an increase in lens size and lens cost, but with excellent rectilinear distortion. Adding partial Scheimpflug to this can reduce the lens size and cost and not create a largely distorted image as would be when using Scheimpflug only. A trade-off can be made to determine how much distortion is acceptable by combining partial DMD offset and partial Scheimpflug and its impact on lens size, which impacts cost. Here we show an example trade-off analysis to show the relationship between image distortion and lens size depending on the projection lens architecture. We assume a 0.23-inch diagonal DMD with f1.7 optics, a 20-inch image diagonal at an 8-inch throw distance with 3-inch image offset. It is important to note that other variations of image size, throw distance, and offset is possible but requires a similar trade-off analysis. Looking at the table, we can see that using DMD offset only, which equates to 160% offset for these set of specifications, 0% distortion can be achieved with a projection lens of 14.85 millimeters in diameter. On the other side of the spectrum, we can use Scheimpflug only to achieve the image offset, which reduces the lens size down to 10.36 millimeters, but at the expense of a high 44.4% distortion. When using a combination of Scheimpflug and 100% DMD offset, 13.1% image distortion can be achieved with a 11.46 millimeter diameter lens. The trade-off between lens size and distortion can be made by the customer to determine what is acceptable for the end product. However, this poses the question, how much electronic distortion correction is realistic? Through the use of image processing, a keystone distorted image can be corrected to a rectilinear image. This, however, results in a partial loss of resolution and a reduction in brightness. The example shown here is an image with 13.1% image distortion, which results from the architecture combining 100% DMD offset and partial Scheimpflug. As you can see, the trapezoidal image shape needs to be cropped to a rectangular shape. The usable image area shows that 10.5% of the projected image area is cropped, and thus 10.5% of the brightness of the image is lost. While the 0.23-inch diagonal DMD can project up to 1080p resolution, the resolution of the cropped usable image area can be calculated. In this example, instead of 1080p resolution, a maximum of approximately 1437 by 762 pixels can be viewed once the keystone image is electronically corrected to a fully rectilinear image. Of course, the customer can determine if not all of the keystone distortion needs to be corrected and gain some of that resolution and brightness back. Thank you for your attention.